All right, guys, I'm going to show you. I've got this way I'm photographing coins now. There is another way you can use a sheet of glass and you kind of tip it over the coin like that, and you have the light in front. You see the light there, just, and it reflects down. But I found this is quite a good way. So this is a plastic milk bottle, carton, whatever you call it. You see, I cut it through there, and there's my coin on a bit of plastic. And then all I do is, I'm going to show you this camera. This isn't the camera I actually use, this is my older one. So it's the same make, but a more modern one, a little one. And I can kind of drop the camera there and let go of it. And then I have the 2 second timer, so there's no wobble. And I just... this is a LED daylight bulb, and I just kind of manipulate it. Also adjust the f-stop, I think it is. So when your camera, if it's got an f-stop setting, this one similar to this, the f-stop is just this, so you can wind it up and down. The one I got now, I can actually see the image. That one didn't show, you just have to kind of up and down. So there's the coin. So this is the view. So this is the camera I actually use. So I would balance it on there. Let me show you. So I've let go of the camera now, so it's all stable. Oh, I can show you. Right, and then just... Oh, look, it's showing up quite well there. So you kind of... You imagine you're taking a picture, and then you just rock it backwards and forwards, and you get different effects. Get the best out of your... thing. And then it's so you've got a little light tent effect, and when that gets dirty, just chuck it away and make a new one. Right, hope that helps, guys. Cheers, bye.